I'm Lacey Wildd. I'm 45 years old. I have 6 wonderful children, and it's taken me $250,000 to build the most extreme plastic body in the world. I'm not obsessed with just one part of my body. I'm obsessed with the entire look. I've had 29, maybe 30 surgeries. So I have 12 breast augmentations, 2 tummy tucks, 3 Brazilian butt lifts, illegal silicone in my lips, 3 full body lipos, and an internal corset. I don't get high when I have surgery, but I do get a little thrill out of thinking I'm gonna wake up looking different, you know? I know that when I walk in a room, everybody like swallows the canary. Do I like that? I guess I do, because I'm living it, you know?
It's just annoying. You're like, Lacey Wildd. It's just, I can't go anywhere without people swarming over her.
I think that I'm lucky to have my mom as a mom. My mom's a great mom. But other people see her almost like a clown, because she's got larger than life features and a larger than life personality.
I want to give everyone an idea of where I started and where I ended. So they start out very modest. The first bra, I was a double A, 32 double A, and this one's triple L. I started out as a little tiny, stringy, slim, brown-headed, flat-chested little girl to a big-breasted, big-lipped cartoon character, Lacey Wildd.
My mom is famous because of her boobs. I just like them because they can pay the rent and stuff.
Is there anything else you like about them?
No. Because it's just disgusting.
It's more of a nuisance finding something to fit me, because it's really hard for me to get things over the hump. So I get it to the point where I can get it here. Here comes the problem. This. And the reason I did my butt is, as I got older, I kind of got a flatter butt. It was like I was driving a Bentley in the front, but it was crashed in the back, you know? The first Brazilian butt lift I had, I think it gave me a little bit more shape. Then I said, you know, let me get another one. I've been talking 10 grand every time I have my booty done. So I went one more time. So I have a $30,000 butt. So now where I used to be able to step into something and get right into it, now my butt is in the way. This is gonna be funny. I don't even know. Now I gotta get it over my butt. This is the problem. The doctor took pigskin and he sewed together my muscles on the sides from the top to the bottom so that my stomach is brought in like this. It's anchored to the muscles right here, and it feels like guitar strings. That's it. I need help getting them. I can't breathe. Ugh. Whew. I can't see like that too long. I can't breathe very well. I actually live around my boobs. The world rotates around them. A lot of people don't know, but I can actually serve champagne off my breasts. If you have a flashlight, I can show you something that will drop jaws across the world. Are you ready? So what do you think of that? I got my own jack-o'-lanterns. But there's a lot of things I can't do if I'm not laying at a 30-degree angle. I do feel like I'm being suffocated. This is why I can't sleep in my stomach, because my breasts are so huge. I have a pillow between my breasts, and then I have to put it between my knees to align my spine. And then, so I have like 4 or 5 pillows I sleep with. I can't even tell you the last time I could see my toes or my feet.
Is it hard to give your mom a hug?
Yes. Well, I just give it under her boobs, so I don't have to... They don't have to crush me.
my mom has always had enlarged breasts since I was a kid. I remember, you know, having friends over at my house, and they'll sneak like a cell phone shot of her, like in her bikini top or whatever.
Doctors don't want me to do it. Doctors tell me, you know, you've got to worry about your ribs caving in. You got to worry about your skin not being able to handle it. If it's just because, oh, there's a possibility you could die, I'm still going to do the surgery.
I don't know how much larger my mom wants to get her boobs. Even if she told me, I probably couldn't comprehend the size.
There are days that I wish I could just, you know, be the old Paula. Do I regret doing it? No, absolutely not.
Going larger, I think, would probably be a danger to her. If she keeps on going, it'll get very scary.